Hey, what's up guys? Virility here, finally uploading a new video. This time it's going to be another review. I guess this is technically only the third review I've done. It's not really something that I plan on getting in the habit of doing. I prefer doing build logs and that sort of thing, but this particular case I felt like needed to be reviewed because I actually just stumbled upon this and kind of had high hopes for it. There's not a lot of information out there about it. I didn't really find any good reviews on YouTube, so I figured I would go ahead and do one myself. So I ordered this from Amazon. It was $240, which is kind of pricey for a case. I was hoping that the price would be justified, and as you see here as we go through this, you'll kind of catch my opinion on that. But I guess the things that stand out the most right away is the tempered glass top and then the aluminum front panel, which would lead you to believe that you're going to be getting a good quality product here, hence the price. But I'm going to go ahead and argue with that as we go on. But first, let's address the literal elephant in the room. This thing's quite large. Now, to be fair, if you compare it to, you know, just a normal computer case and kind of turn it on its side, it's really not any bigger than that. But considering the fact that this is touted as an HTPC case, that's kind of how they're advertising it. It's actually, it's friggin' huge. So it is 19.5 inches wide. It's 9.5 inches tall, and it's about 18 inches deep. And to put that into perspective, I measured my Denon audio receiver, which the audio receiver tends to be the largest component in a home theater setup. And that was 17 inches wide, 7 inches tall, and 14 inches deep. So when you do the math and compare the volume of each component, this thing is literally twice as large as my audio receiver. So I don't really know how this is going to comfortably fit in someone's like home theater setup. I mean, I'm not saying it's impossible, but it's big. So just keep that in mind if it's something that you're considering. I would say it looks okay. Personally, I'm not a fan of the front here. That wasn't really going to be an issue for me. I knew what I was getting into, but I was planning on modding this whole thing anyway, so this would be gone. But it is aluminum. It's a little bit on the thinner side, in my opinion, but I guess it's fine. It feels sturdy. The buttons look chintzy. It's like a plastic panel, so I think it's odd that you've got a nice aluminum front and then kind of these cheap looking buttons. But you got power reset, you've got a tiny little LED button here because this thing here is RGB, which again, probably a little bit flashier than what I would prefer in a case like this, but I wasn't going to use this anyway, so whatever. Two USB 3.0 type A, and then you've got a type C, which is pretty cool. That's actually a pass-through, and I'll show you here. Then, of course, the tempered glass top to show off the goodies. The front is kind of a gap here. This is a fan here, if you're wondering. This is to allow airflow. There's no feet on this case, and we're going to talk about that here, but even though there's a gap in the bottom, you'd have a hard time taking air in the bottom. The top's covered by the tempered glass, so really you've got air coming in both sides as far as the front intake is concerned. Now, what makes this case so unique, and one of the things that drew me to it, I thought it was a really cool idea, is it's kind of a shell. So this inner part pulls out like a drawer. There's actually casters on the bottom. And not only does it pull out, it allows you to work with the case. And here I got to move this back. This thing's so flipping huge that even on my kitchen table, It takes up so much space. So to get into the inside here, and as you can see, the casters are awesome. Probably about the only thing that, not the only thing, but just as far as ease of working in this case, it's all open. As you can see, it's a horizontal layout. So you've got, I'm just going to start and go around, and you can find these features online anyway, but front support for dual 140 or dual 120 fan / radiator. You've got a pretty good amount of space for any radiator thickness here. These guys here are little trays that hold SSDs. Left side here, you can hold a couple hard drives, a couple more SSDs. This whole thing can come off, and there's two fan mounts. Power supply goes here. You've got support for any size motherboard, basically. And then over on this side here, you've got triple 120 with, I guess, an adequate amount of space for, I think you've got between 55 and 60 millimeters. So you could do a 360 rad over here, although I'm suspicious about some of the spacing here. Rear 120 millimeter fan. This fan comes with the case. It's the only fan included, and it is probably the most hideous fan I have ever seen. I don't know why someone that pays over $200 for a case would also be a fan of a obnoxious green fan, but hey, at least they sleeved the cable, so there's that. So aside from that, pretty straightforward. I will say probably the good things about this case is that you've got a lot of flexibility. You can definitely do some interesting water cooling loops in here, which is what I was planning on doing. And then ease of working in. It's, I guess it's an RA case if you're looking for that sort of flexibility. I can't see anyone using this as an HTPC just because of how large this is. But if space is not a concern for you and you've got a lot of stuff that you want to cram in here, this is potentially a good case for you. But I guess I want to talk about all the issues. One is this shell here, if you'll notice, it has no feet. Now, it doesn't technically need to be raised off of the ground as far as airflow is concerned, and I think that they probably did this so that you could roll this guy right in here. But here's the deal. You load this thing up with components. It's already a huge case. There's no way to grab this thing. There's no handles. You can't get your fingers underneath it. And if you want to slide this around on a wood surface, you got to worry about, you know, steel edges grinding into the, I mean, it's, to me, that's a huge oversight. This scenario here, where you drive this little caddy in and out of it, would never exist in a normal HTPC environment. Like, you need so much space to roll this out. You have to move this on to a table. I mean, to roll this out, you need 3 feet, right? No, where are people going to keep this thing that they're going to drive this thing right out? Okay. I like the idea, but it would make more sense. You're going to pull this out, and then you're probably going to grab it, you know, with your hands, pull it out, and then lift it, and then move it somewhere else. But in the advent that you have to move the entire case, you want to be able to have a way to grab it. Not to mention, there's 4 thumb screws that you can use to secure this into the back, which either you have to have a way to reach behind there and undo them. I mean, it doesn't make any sense. That's all I'm going to say. I mean, to me, the thing should have had feet. Every other component in your, you know, home theater setup is going to have, you know, feet on it. If you want it to match, or you want it to make sense, or you want to make it easy to move around, it's got to have feet. I think this is just flat out stupid. Again, just my opinion, but there's that. As far as the layout goes on the inside, so the positioning of the grommets to me is peculiar. Now, these ones all make sense. This one sort of makes sense, although that when you put a power supply in here, it's going to kind of cover up a section of it. And then this one here is awesome if you're using like a micro ATX board, but it's completely covered up with full ATX. And then there's no way to really discreetly route cables other than pulling them out of here. This is the configuration it comes in where the cables are kind of poking out of here. And while I'm talking about it, we need to talk about this. So the audio cable, all right, on almost every board, that connector is going to be somewhere down in this lower left-hand corner. And let's say you put a full ATX board in here. This thing, it doesn't reach. You know, maybe you can pull it out of this one here and gain a little more slack. But who really wants to have this cable like just running across diagonally across their motherboard? Like that would look terrible. So you either need an extension or, I mean, heck, I haven't even tried moving this, but maybe if you had micro ATX and it came out of here, it would fit, but that's about the only scenario I can imagine. So I don't know. I mean, look how long the front panel, I mean, you could plug these in anywhere and this basically goes here. So seems like a silly oversight on their part. Grommet here sort of makes sense for your 8-pin EPS and possibly maybe some fan connectors. However, if you were to populate this with either three fans or three fans plus a radiator, you're basically going to butt right up to the board. Now, one area here where I think they made a huge mistake, they positioned these mounts way too low in the tray. They had a ton of space to work with. They could have raised these up so that when you mounted the stuff in here, you had space underneath the fans and the radiator to run cables, you know, discreetly hide fan cables and that sort of thing. But it's going to be pushed so far down and against the motherboard that it's going to be jam-packed. You're going to have to run cables across stuff. Now, granted, I haven't tried this. I didn't see any reason to bother putting components in here because I'm just going to be sending it back. But I can already envision, having done many builds, that's going to be an issue there. I think that you should comfortably be able to fit 280 and a 360 in here. It says that it'll support more fans and another radiator over here, which technically I believe is true. However, you can't do it all at once. Like, you're going to run into issues with things, you know, just not fitting properly. I think there's definitely potential here. I think you could do some pretty neat stuff, but you know, another thing I should note that I will commend them on is, as far as the underside is concerned, there is a good amount of, you know, tie downs. There's tons of space for cable management. You actually get quite a bit of room to work with. So not only could you easily route cables under here, you could probably even pass through like water cooling tubing and stuff like that. So you can see these caster wheels here. Another interesting thing, which at this point doesn't surprise me, but it made zero sense to me. So the front wheels have little locking mechanisms on them. The back ones don't. So one, I don't see a scenario where this is going to make sense, unless you wanted it to sit outside of this by itself and you didn't want it to move around. All right, maybe. But it was shipped to me with these front wheels in the locked position, so that as I was trying to pull it out of here, there was quite a bit of resistance, and it kind of made me feel like I was doing something wrong. So that was another thing that I thought was a little odd. I couldn't see myself ever putting these in the locking positions. I don't know. I guess it's all right, but you can see where the USB Type C connector passes through. It actually comes out the back so you can plug it in. I actually like that. That way, you know, I know the newer motherboards have the Type C, you know, kind of front panel connector, but a lot of your older boards might have Type C in the back, but not necessarily for the front. So that gives you that option to get that pass through there. But so that being said, I have a lot of complaints. There's some neat things about this case, but the number one complaint I had was, and I'll show you, this is the box that it was shipped in. Very nice, dense foam. It was wrapped in just a plastic bag. So I think overall it was packaged well. But my tempered glass panel, now I may have a few fingerprints on here, but there's a big like scuff across the center. There was no protective film on here. And then I don't know how well I can get this to show up, but it's gonna be tough with reflections. There's a chip in it. There's a chip in the glass. So the glass was just, it was never handled well in the factory when this thing was assembled. They ratcheted, I shouldn't say ratcheted, but they tightened down the thumb screws with a flathead screwdriver, and you can see the gouges, you know, where they made them so tight. To me is unnecessary. I mean, you're already getting components that are damaged, and maybe I'm being picky here, but the fact of the matter is you're paying over $200 for this case. I have a, you know, my main system right now is in a Case Labs Mercury S5. I paid $360 for that case. Never once have questioned whether or not I got my money's worth. This case here, I've built in cases half this price that I feel had better, shouldn't say better, but compared to what you pay in the build quality, like this just, it doesn't scream quality to me. It doesn't look like a case that should cost over $200. Granted, that's my opinion, but I think they either need to fix a couple things so that you feel like you're getting your money's worth. For one, that fan looks cheap as hell. It's so bad looking. Like, what? Like, really? Let's just take a moment to appreciate how hideously ugly this fan is. And this, it's like sophisticated, crazy. What are they thinking here? This is chintzy. You know, a Vandal switch would have been nicer. They cut a lot of corners. This guy's falling out because I tipped it, but that's a removable filter for the front. This is crap. I'm rambling here, but stuff I didn't mention. There are magnetic filters on that outer shell for all the vents there as well. So, you know, that's that. In my opinion, they probably should have included a couple more fans. Like, even if it was like a single 140 and then a single 120 back here of a nicer quality fan, or at least not ugly green, that would have been better. I don't know. I wouldn't recommend this case to anyone, is basically what it boils down to. If it suits a very specific need for you, then I say go for it. There's definitely a lot of potential here. You could do a really cool build in here. I would love to do a nice water-cooled build in here, but I'm not, to me, I feel like I'm throwing my money away. If this case was $150, maybe. Maybe I would consider it, but at $200, I pay $240. I think you could buy it direct from their site for $200, although probably pay shipping, so it probably comes out to be about the same. So let's just call it what it is. They have it listed at an MSRP of $299, which is even more outrageous, considering you get one aluminum panel, the rest of it is thin steel, and they don't even take really good care in, you know, assembling and you know, shipping this thing out. It does have a nice user manual, I guess. No, you know, it's one of the nicer ones I've seen. I don't know what's in this box because I didn't open it, but I would assume it's all your screws and stuff. Like, you know, there's nothing in there that's going to be, you know, crazy out of the ordinary compared to what's included. I mean, it's not a nice divided plastic case like Fantex has with theirs, but, you know, it is what it is. So anyway, I'm going to stop here. I feel like I've said everything that needs to be said. I've rambled on. You know, hopefully this is giving people enough information to help them make a buying decision. Again, this is just my opinion, you know, on the case. You know, it's not terrible. It's just not worth the money. That's That's all I'm going to say. I think they could fix a few things. I wouldn't even mind them charging more money. Charge me $250. Just give me what I'm paying for, you know? Make me feel like I'm getting a $250 case. I mean, you're getting into the realm of, like, you know, once you get up to around $300, I mean, you got to compete with, like, Inwin, Lee & Lee, you know, Case Labs is even more than that. But still, I mean, you got some serious competition, and you're talking about competing with aluminum cases, with glass and more fans, and just overall better. So Nanoxia, if anyone from your company watches this video, just keep that stuff in mind when maybe you do a version 2 of this case. But for right now, this thing seriously lacks identity as a premium case as far as for what you're paying. So anyway, if you guys like this video, go ahead and, you know, give me a thumbs up. I gotta pander that. Subscribe. I don't really post videos that often, and I probably will do more build logs, but I do my best to just be honest, and when I come across stuff like this, try to share the information. So anyway, you guys have a good day.